What we've been working on in this lab is electrospinning nanofiber membranes to use as masks to filter out particles and things such as viruses. N95 mask supply is running short right now, and there aren't very many things that you can use to get the same filtration.
So this is a nanofiber filter membrane. It actually stretches quite a bit, and you can breathe through it.
We're trying to create a process so that people can coat the masks that they already have with our nanofibers so that they can be more protected.
We're taking existing masks and just upgrading them. This process will make available more effective masks to more people.
The process we use is called electrospinning.
We take a liquid polymer, which we then push through a tube at high voltage, and it stretches this polymer nice and thin into nanofibers. We then spray these nanofibers across a material evenly, but in a random manner in which it creates a nice filter.
Because we use such a high voltage to create these nanofibers, they retain kind of a static charge. Tiny particles will be statically attracted to the mask and will not be able to go through the mask.
You've got basically trillions and trillions of fibers here, and the static electricity, the same stuff that will make it cling to my finger, is the same stuff that captures all these particulates. This material is great for masks because it's excellently breathable. Current N95 masks are hot. They're hard to breathe through. You can have the best mask in the world, but if you won't wear it because it's uncomfortable, it's worthless.
Electrospinning, you can spin onto any fabric.
Lay the fibers in between, and now you've got a mask. What our process does is allows you to upgrade these cloth face masks and turn your mask into a highly effective N95 mask.
We have done tests using a port account, which is something that OSHA also uses to test their masks.
N95 mask means 95% effective.
We've gotten in the range from 95 to 99 with recent tests that we've done.
There are 1,400 ambient particles, and apparently we're getting through the mask.
We are helping to get this technology out there for others to use, and we're trying to help protect people all around the world.